Okay, so today we talk about the MySQL workbench. This is a client to connect MySQL database where you will be able to run queries. If you want to create a connection, new connection, you just click on this and provide the credential and connect. I have already created one connection, but right now we need to talk about how to create a model or ERD diagram. So I clicked on this. I'm clicking on new. So here we can add a new diagram here. Let me click on this. I will change it to blog post dash or maybe underscore. Here I will select UTF-8 MB4 and I would specifically go for Unicode UTF-8 Unicode underscore CI. So this is this should be my default collation where I want to save. So I want to save it into a specific location. So blog post is our project. It contains an install folder and then it contains a DB folder, or you can call it model. So I keep this model in my project so that if somebody has to change something, they can directly change in this file. Okay, and please remember this applies on the MySQL because this is MySQL workbench. It help you create schema with that, and we can benefit from it in so many things by generating the queries, etc. So I want to create a table naming convention. So usually we just prefix our table, so blog post with posts. So this is a simple site where you can read the blog, you can read different posts. So we are trying to create a table for it. So I prefixed it with the blog post and then I'm writing the table name. Here we'll create blog underscore ID begint, auto increment unsigned. Auto increment, its value will be automatically assigned and it will increase by one. Unsigned means any data type which usually refer to a number has a positive and negative number. So we are just saying that we just want to use unsigned, mean where it's signed that it's a positive number or a negative number. So it split the range into two. So it split the overall capacity into two ranges. One is positive, one is negative. So we only want to consume the complete storage as a positive. So that's why we are saying it should be an unsigned data type. Then we will have title and we would use varchar 256. Why? Because I want to apply an index, a text-based index, so that it can quickly search it. So for that we need at maximum support 256 character. And then we will have description here where we can have 500 words. So this is anything you want to write. Then we can use keywords which we usually print on the page for the bots to crawl our page and they can read your site based on these keywords. So I will use 500 and then the body. If it is a small body, so we'll go with the text, which is a lot more bigger than this number. But again, this has a limit. We'll discuss about this once we breach this limit. So I'm gonna have a flag which is published. It should be enum type. Published, yes, no, or rejected. Okay, and if we want to have the default value for this, so by default nothing would be published here, so we are marking it not published. Okay, so that's it. The things that I need, I will delete this extra column. So this is our table here. We have created all the fields. We'll save. Let's close it. And now I'm going to create a categories table. Again, I will edit this prefix with my database. Why we prefix? There are so many reasons. Sometimes you get the hosting where you are allowed only to create one database. So if your tables are prefixed separately, it's really easy to create all the tables in one database and then use them. The second thing that you can use, why you can use it to make it difficult for people to guess your table's name, but if he knows your technique, it's really easy for them to understand. But you can use any three random number for your database. Here I will use the categories table. I'm going to create a category ID, and again this is big int, auto increment and unsigned. So here we look at this website, which is mysqldev.mysql.com. You can see here the integer is of 4 bytes, whereas big int is of 8 bytes, and the number integer can store is from minus this number to maximum this number. So it is a signed integer, that's why it has a range in the negative value and range for the positive value. The maximum value that we can save if it is unsigned, so it's a huge number. If we use the big int, which is 8 byte, if we use unsigned, so it's really big number. So let's say this tool or website, or you are creating for everyone, maybe like Medium, where different people come in and create their own website and article. So this number should be really big. For now, big int is enough for us. Okay, so we will have a category name here, and then we'll have 255 characters. Okay, let's save this and close this. I think that's enough. Now I want to create the relation. I always create relation by going here and name it like FK, so it's a foreign key. So this is key name, and the key name is very important. We are trying to create this relation on post, and the other table would be category, or you can just call it, yeah. So on the post table, I'm building the relation for the category, and here the reference table would be categories. Okay, we didn't create that column, so let's go there and create here the column. It should be category underscore ID, and it should be big integer, the same as on the other side. If you do not use the same data type or unsigned value, then it won't let you create the relation. Okay, now if I click here, so we can see here the category ID. So we are building this relation. So if these both columns does not match due to the data type, due to the signed unsigned flag, it won't let you create that relation. Okay, at least not this tool. So now the referential integrity, so how it we can enforce it. On update, we want to update the child record. So if the ID is changed in the parent table, it must change in the child table as well. So parent table here is the category table, the child table here is the post table. And on delete, so if somebody delete a category, it will automatically delete all the post in it, or we want to restrict. So this is the safer option. We don't want it to do this, because this is going to create a problem for us. So it should restrict and throw an error, which we will see once we start writing code for it. From that error, we will be able to understand there are some child records. So we first need to delete them or move those posts to a different category. Okay, let's save this, and let's create another table here. I'm going to name it so blog post app version. So title, if you want to mention any title, we can use 256 character. So I'm using all small case, all with underscore. So here we will have to save the number, and for default we can use now. So whenever this execute, it will enter the current date, current timestamp. So this is a Unix epoch. Okay, and that's it. I want version ID 1, title, and updated, etc. Let's go here for the insert. So I want to create insert here. I'll click on this. So we are going to version ID, new installation, and yeah, let's not provide this. Let's apply this and come back here. Okay, so we have created a table to track the version so that we can upgrade our database whenever there is a change. So let's go to the forward database, forward engineering. Let's export this thing. So this panel will ask you to provide the database connection details. So I have already created a local connection. So local connection, localhost, simple, pretty straightforward. There is a next button here. I will click on it. It asks me to skip creation of foreign key, generate index. So there are a couple of options. I don't want to use any of them. I just want to use omit schema qualifier and object name. Why I'm using this? Because I do not want it to write the database name every time it creates a resource in my database. So before the table name, I wanted to use generate use statement so that it select the proper database. Okay, let's go next. So here I want to export MySQL table and objects. If you have other things, you can select options accordingly, but usually we just select this option. Now we click on this and it has generated some code for us. So let's look at this code. So here it is trying to save unique check previous value. So whatever the value of the unique check is, it saves all the configuration first and then override all the configurations. So here it is saving the current value of unique check into an old variable and then set it to zero. So it's basically disabling unique check, it's disabling foreign key and couple of other things. It's disabling all of them, but before disabling them, it is also trying to save them as well. So here if we come down, we can see here, so create schema if it does not exist, so it would be blog post. So default character set is the something that I wanted. So our character set is UTF-8 MB4 and collation is UTF-8 MB4 underscore Unicode CI. Why we chose this, I will explain it in a later videos. Now here we want to use the blog post, or this will select the current database that is just created. After that is trying to create the table. If it does not exist, so it will create it. This is our big int unsigned not null auto increment field. Category ID 256 character supposed to be, but I just missed. Then this is an extra column. We need to remove this. It's really easy. We go back here, edit this, and we'll have 256. Yes. Okay, and we need to delete this extra column. Save this again, close it again. Forward engineering, all the option will remain as it is. Next, and here we can see now that extra field is fixed. Another table we are trying to create is blog post, which is title, description, all those fields. And then we have a primary key, then we are creating an index. So on primary key, index is automatically created. Then we are applying a constraint. It's a foreign key constraint. Post has a constraint over the category, or the category ID would be used here as a foreign key. So this is the field here in the current table, and it will match against category ID of the categories table. On delete, we want to restrict this. We don't want to allow it. On update, we want to update this. Engine is NODB for this table as well. And similarly, for the app version, we just created a new table. Okay, so here we have table, but I think there's something missing. So let's go back and try to, okay, here we can see the option, generate insert statements for the table. So I just clicked on this, and when I go to the new screen, now I can see here app version with everything, yeah, and new installation. So here is that missing, something is missing here. We'll fix that. Let's go here, and in the inserts we can say, yeah, now let's apply this. Okay, and again do the forward engineering. So once you have learned this, it's really easy. Now we can see the statements. So what is happening, it is currently, so first it save all the current configuration, then it override all the configuration to speed up the process. That's how migration scripts are written usually. So this is not something special with MySQL workbench. This is how things are done. You first disable all the checks, you create your table, you make all the changes, then restore all the restriction, all the configuration, all the checks. So here we are just restoring it because we saved them previously, and then we start working on our work, which is basically insertion of the record, and then we just commit it. So let's save this. We'll save it into the same path, in blog post install db. So here we will say first install, or just call it install.sql. So whenever somebody has to create the database, he or she needs to run this script on the database, and just press cancel and we are back here. So that's how we were able to create our database. In second part, we look at how to make the changes into this database and publish those changes. So how can we do that? So stay tuned. Thank you. Bye.